You may have heard the term contact tracing in the news lately, and unless you work in public health, you're probably wondering what it is. Contact tracing starts with identification of someone with COVID-19, and it means trying to find out who has been exposed by that person. For example, household members, friends, or others with whom the ill person has had close contact. Public health agencies do tracing like this regularly, most commonly as they investigate foodborne illness outbreaks or infectious illnesses like sexually transmitted infections or measles that spread from person to person. Contact tracing is important for identifying people who may have been exposed to COVID-19 and counseling them about symptoms to watch for and how to prevent spread to others. Along with personal measures like hand washing, covering your cough, and social distancing, it has been and will be an important tool for combating the virus in Oregon. Oregon public health officials began to use contact tracing since the arrival of COVID-19 cases in Oregon. It is usually done by local public health authorities in Oregon and sometimes by state public health workers. The public health officials attempt to interview every laboratory-confirmed case of COVID-19 to determine the source of their infection, if possible, and to identify those with whom they have recently had contact, especially persons who are at risk of severe illness and persons who might in turn spread the infection to lots of other people. Public health investigators will look for contacts from 2 days prior to when the patient first began experiencing symptoms of COVID-19. High-priority contacts include residents, inmates, or staff in long-term care facilities, correctional facilities, and other high-risk congregate settings, and workers in critical infrastructure, especially those in healthcare. Other high-priority contacts include people who are older than 60 years old, pregnant women, and people with underlying medical conditions, such as cardiac or respiratory conditions, diabetes, blood disorders, or who are immunocompromised. These individuals are then notified of their potential exposure, advised of what symptoms to watch for, and educated about basic preventive measures, including physical distancing, cough etiquette, hand washing, sanitizing of frequently touched surfaces, and how to self-isolate if they develop symptoms. To summarize, contact tracing is a valuable tool for public health officials to reduce disease transmission, but it relies on citizens answering the calls or letters from the local health authorities and then acting on the recommendations they give. So if you or someone you know are contacted by health authorities, please heed their advice. Working together and using tools like contact tracing, we will more quickly get to the end of the COVID-19 epidemic.